The Philippines has given a $750 million World Bank loan. This is to support climate resilience efforts. The loan aims to help the Philippines achieve its goal. That's to get half of its energy needs from renewable sources by 2040. It'll also fund new insurance products for small-scale farmers and strengthen the Philippine Crop Insurance Commission. A portion of the funds will be used on waste management and on strengthening enforcement of the Extended Producer Responsibility Act. Now, this law gives companies a 2028 deadline to recover up to 80% of their plastic waste. The Philippine Senate Bill on Public-Private Partnerships is certified as urgent by President Marcos Jr. The bill provides guidelines on private sector projects that may be financed partly from direct government appropriations or official development assistance from foreign governments. Now, the president's certification was addressed to the Senate in May, but was only released to the media Wednesday. The lower house approved its version of the bill last year.
Tourists from India and China would soon have an easier time securing a Philippine visa. The Philippine Information and Communications Technology says it is set to launch an electronic visa system for the two countries. ICT Secretary Ivan Uy says they have been working with relevant agencies, including the Bureau of Immigration, in developing the system. He believes this will help further boost tourist arrivals from two of the world's most populous nations.
The Philippine Justice Department eyeing the use of artificial intelligence profiling at airports to thwart human trafficking cases. That's after the Immigration Bureau reported they offload around 20 departing passengers daily for suspicion of trafficking at Naiya. During the first coordination meeting of the Task Force Against Trafficking, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Ramilla said AI can help in vetting the identities of airport passengers. The Immigration Commissioner Norman Tansico noted, profiling and processing travelers is challenging, especially since Naiya experiences daily congestion.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. orders his cabinet members to study the nearly 197 million peso fund being requested by Albay to continue supporting evacuees. Marcos flew to Albay Wednesday to monitor relief efforts for communities affected by Mayon volcano's eruption. During the meeting on Mayon's restiveness, Governor Ed Seligman said over 33,000 families may be forced to evacuate should Mayon be placed under alert level 4. He adds the province's 30 million peso quick response fund could only sustain evacuees for about 2 weeks, far from the 90-day evacuation window they're eyeing.
The province is already providing all of this, the 30 million. We will have to make up the difference for the continuing in terms of, I suppose, food, non-food items, and all the other arrangements that we are going to have to make. The final figure of 166,711,000 is something that we can dig. I think that the numbers that the governor has given us are a good guide already, but we have to go into further detail.
As of Wednesday, over 16,000 Albay residents have been evacuated. State volcanologists earlier warned Mayon's unrest could continue for months, forcing thousands to stay longer in temporary shelters.
Technical aircraft issues delayed the trip of Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to the province of South Cotabato. But Marcos still made it to the province, where he distributed nearly 43 million pesos worth of aid to various sectors. Katrina Domingo reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. arrived in South Cotabato nearly 3 hours behind his original schedule. According to Presidential Communications Office Secretary Cheloy Garafil, the first aircraft encountered technical issues mid-air, forcing pilots to return to the Villamor Air Base and transfer the president to a different plane. The Philippine Air Force says the minor technical issue involves the plane's flaps operations. An Air Force spokesperson adds, it was nothing serious, but since they maintain the highest standards of flying safety, the pilots decided to return to base and have the aircraft checked. Marcos Jr. arrived safely in South Cotabato shortly before noon, and his first order of business in the town of Banga, head to the ceremonial distribution of farm equipment and machineries to several cooperatives, which is part of the Department of Agriculture's Mechanization and Modernization Program.
Ginagawa natin ito maging mas efficient. Yung buong proseso na pagsasaka, yung supply ng bigas ay kailangan natin tiyakin. Pangalawa, pababain natin yung presyo. Magkaroon naman ng magandang hanap buhay ang ating mga magsasaka. Kung hindi naman naging magandang hanap buhay ng magsasaka, ay sayang lang ang ating ginawa.
South Cotabato Governor Reynaldo Tamayo says the program intends to improve the yield and income of farmers and somehow pull down the 18% poverty incidence rate to a single-digit statistic.
Ito mga magsasaka natin, sila yung karamihan na nasa below poverty line. Ngayon kung tataas yung ani nila, marireduce yung poverty rate.
The president also led the awarding of some 42.79 million pesos worth of government aid for farmers and workers. Among the aid packages distributed in Coronadal City are cash assistance for farmers, seed money for former overseas Filipino workers who wish to open small businesses, and starter tool kits for Filipinos who recently graduated from short courses. The president hopes that through these programs, his administration will somehow fulfill his campaign promise of improving the quality of life in the Philippines, despite the post-pandemic economy and other global headwinds. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News, Coronadal City.
President Marcos orders the construction of water impounding facilities near Metro Manila. He instructed the Water Management Office to devise a flood control plan for Metro Manila and coastal communities. He says water collected from the impounding facilities can be repurposed. Now, state agencies are still identifying potential locations for the impounding areas, and the flood control projects in Metro Manila and adjacent areas are estimated to cost around 351 billion pesos.